Hey there, handsome.
Hi there.
Joe ain't here right now. He said for you to meet him for lunch at Freddy's.
I see.
Too bad you were passed out when I came in. We could have partied. Maybe next time, doll. Bye.
Huh. That was something.
Broad, get the hell back here! If you can't drive, you should stay home where you belong!
Hey, isn't that Joe's girl over there? Well, one of them anyway.
You smacked up my car, I'm gonna smack up yours! Look at my fucking car!
Hey, pal, knock it off.
And who the fuck are you?
Somebody who doesn't like hearing you talk to a lady like that. So why don't you shut the fuck up and leave while I'm still in a good mood, huh?
What, is she your girlfriend or something? Well, if she's not gonna pay for it, you will.
One more word, and you're gonna need a new set of teeth. Now get the fuck out of here. That was the word.
Thanks, handsome. I owe you one. Do you want to come over to my place for a piece of pie?
Yeah, thanks, but look, I really gotta get going.
You'll like it, I promise. I gotta get going now. I'll see you around.
Hey, fellas.
Hey. Hey, Vito, this is Luca Garino. He'd like to talk to you and Joe. Luca, this is Vito.
Good to meet you, Mr. Garino.
No need to be so formal. Call me Luca. Take a seat, Vito.
What can I get you?
Same thing I'm having. And hurry it up. I heard about you running with the mix. Great fucking story. And I want to congratulate you, too, on a job well done. Salute.
A salute.
You guys did a hell of a job. Not too many guys got the stomach for this line of work. So now, I'm wondering if yous are ready to take the next step.
Yeah, sure. What next step?
I'm talking about taking somebody out. Just because someone points his finger at him and tells you to do it.
this story as the information comes in, and...
I was in the war, Mr. Guarino. All I did was kill people I was told to kill. People the president pointed his finger at.
That's good. The president. Yeah, I like that. Yeah. But you're talking about the Krauts, right? You know, the bad guys. That's not what I mean. Understand?
Yeah, I understand.
Good. We need guys like you. Guys who can follow orders without asking questions. You handle this next job like you handled the last one, and there's a good chance you'll be accepted into the family. After you pay the initiation fee, of course.
And how much is that?
$5,000 apiece.
That's a fucking fortune.
Hey, nobody said it was cheap, huh? But trust me, the benefits far outweigh the cost. I'll leave it up to you two to decide. Henry's gonna fill you in on the rest. I'll see his guys later.
There you are.
Hey, your boss.
You take care of that thing we talked about yet?
Yeah, it's all under control.
That's Henry's what you said the last time. Don't disappoint me again.
Boss,
don't! Now come with me. We got some other business to discuss.
So, Henry, what kind of job we talking about here?
I gotta take a guy out. It's my contract, but
thanks.
I need some help. That's where you two come in.
Who's the lucky guy?
Some fat fuck from across the river. The guy's been warned, but he thinks he's untouchable.
And is he?
Well, somebody tried to take him out once before.
And?
Let's just say they slightly underestimated him.
How much is slightly?
Fatally.
That's a fancy way of saying they're dead, right?
Hey, they fucked up. We won't. I rented an apartment across the street from his business. We'll sit there, and we'll wait till that fat fuck shows up, and then boom! We blast his ass.
How are we gonna do that?
With an MG-42.
Where are we getting an MG-42 from?
Harry.
Yeah.
He's a vet, like you. He's got a private little gun shop over in Kingston. You can get your anything from a pea shooter to a bazooka. And you don't need no fucking gun license, neither.
Okay, Joe and me will go to the apartment. You go pick up the machine gun at Harry's shop in Kingston. It's all paid for. Just tell him I sent you. After that, meet us at the apartment. It's in Sand Island, the building across from the distillery. Apartment 233.
Okay, apartment 233. Got it. I'll meet you fellas there in a bit.
All right, see you later.
Good luck, pal.
Okay, take care.
Good. Hey, you know, I really think the worst of course.
There's gonna be a hallelujah day when the boys have all come home to stay. And the million bands begin to play. We'll be dancing the victory. And when we've lit the torch of liberty, in each black of land across the sea, when a man can proudly say I'm free, we'll be dancing the victory polka.
And we will give a mighty cheer when the ration book is just a souvenir.
Come marching down Fifth Avenue, the United Nations in review. When this lovely dream has all come true, we'll be dancing the victory polka.
Dance, dance, dance the victory polka.
Shine, shine the merry throng.
Sing, sing, sing the victory polka.
Raise your voice as loud as strong.
It's gonna be a great holiday day when the boys have all come home to stay.
And the million bands begin to play.
We'll be dancing the victory. Polka. And when we fled...
Yeah, who is it?
Henry Tomasino sent me to pick up the stuff he ordered.
All right, come in.
Hello?
So, you're the guy Henry was telling me about, huh?
Yeah, you got his merchandise.
Yeah, well, here it is. MG-42, made in Germany. Hitler's buzzsaw, we call them. She's a beauty. 25 pounds. 7.92 caliber, 1,200 rounds per minute, fastest in the world. 250 round belt, 3/4 mile effective range, and extremely reliable. I don't know what the hell you're hunting, but unless it's in a fucking tank, sayonara, baby. Hey, you need me to show you how to use it?
No, thanks. I'm familiar with him. I was in the service, too.
No shit! Wait, you're kidding me. Where were you? What was it, Normandy, huh? No, Africa? Let me guess.
Operation Husky.
Yeah? What unit were you in?
504th Parachute.
No shit, you were a paratrooper? That was kind of hairy, I heard.
Yeah, well, it wasn't no picnic, I tell you. I got hit, so they sent me home.
Yeah, any medals?
Yeah, Purple Heart and a DSC.
Whoa, wait, you got a cross? Let me tell you, they don't give those babies out for nothing. I was in Normandy. We hit Utah Beach. Yeah, that wasn't no picnic neither, but... When I was crawling over the fence on the way back, I poked my eye out on a fucking tree branch. Well, hey, it was good enough for a discharge.
Look, guy, I really gotta get going.
All right. Hey, by the way, I'm Harry.
Hey, Vito.
Hey, good to meet you, Vito. Real good. If you ever need some hardware, you know where to find me. There you go. I hope you drove here. She's a big girl. Good luck.
Hey, thanks. Nice to meet you, Harry.
The gun's in the crate, and there's a couple thousand rounds in the van out in the yard. Take it. It's all paid for. Bicycle,
or you can let the Road King Bus Company take you where you need to go. Not only will
see you around, Vito.
The war effort, but you'll save money too, because Road King Bus Company.
Oh. 2 in Empire Bay. You can make a difference. He was a World War I Navy veteran who entertained his fellow troops while serving his country. He's Jack Benny, and he's a Navy man who would encourage you to join the Navy and help achieve victory over the Japanese in the Pacific. Visit your closest recruitment station and sign up now. Remember, you can make a difference.
Where are you from, Henry?
Sicily.
What brought you to the States?
Mussolini.
Will you buy your ticket?
Don't be a smartass, Joe. My father was a man of honor. Things got pretty bad for us after Mussolini came into power. My old man figured I'd either get drafted or locked up. So he sent me to America and got me a job working for Clementi.
So what happened to your father?
He said he was too old to make the trip. Mussolini had him arrested, and he died in jail. They won't even turn his body over for a proper burial.
That's rough.
So how's your English so good?
They're coming! Those black cars! Vito, aim for the fat bastard. We gotta nail him before he gets in the building. Get ready.
All right, I'm on.
They got
All
guns.
Right, showtime.
They got guns up there in that window.
That's him, Vito. Wait, step back.
We got them all. Stop shooting that fucking thing. I'm going deaf over here.
To get away.
Okay, you first, Vito. You're the fucking war hero.
Go, go, we'll cover you.
We're coming for you, Porky!
Back me up, Vito.
I'll cover you, move it!
Vito.
the hell are you doing, Joe?
What? Thirsty. Pretty good stuff. You should try it.
Drinking on the job, huh? When'd you turn Irish?
Here they come!
Back me up, PS. They got commies. Shit, there's an army of them.
Don't kill me! Please! I got a wife!
You should have thought about your wife before.
I'm doing it, you want? Just don't kill me! Oh, for Christ's sake!
Don Clemente sends his regards. Oh! Fuck!
Fuck you! Sorry, you...
Fuck!
Henry, you okay? Where'd he hit?
Of course I'm not fucking okay. He shot me in the fucking leg!
Oh, yeah, it's bleeding all over.
Son of a... Get me to El Greco.
The fucking painter?
No, the fucking doctor,
okay,
you
take
idiot.
Take it easy. I'm gonna get you there in a minute.
The Greek guy lives up in Highbrook.
All right, let's get you to the car.
Oh, Maradona, you're heavier than you look.
Fuck. He almost shot my balls off.
Take it easy. He missed him by a mile.
Hey, careful! This fucking hurts.
Yeah, well, you can walk if you don't quit your moaning.
Hey, I don't need to get pissy. I'm the one.
No,
please. Leave that here.
I don't want to die.
Let's go, Vito. Andiamo. What the fuck are you waiting for?
Oh. Fuck. This whole fucking place is coming apart.
Oh, damn, son.
Shit! Vito, find a way out!
Go saying that, pal. It's just a scratch. The doc will give you a few stitches, and then we'll all go out and celebrate.
No, really.
Shh. Shh. Talk right now. Helps conserve your strength. We've seen that in a movie once.
Yeah.
And what happened to the guy in the movie?
He died. Jesus, you drive like my fucking grandmother.
I can, damn it.
Well, it ain't fast enough.
Just relax, would you?
I got a hole in my leg the size of a fucking golf ball, and you're telling me to relax? Just get me to El Greco, damn it. Hey, Vito, step on it. Henry smelled like a whore in church back here.
You know what make me drive faster? Tu stadezito.
So, fellas, who is this guy?
What guy?
This guy, taking Henry.
El Greco? He's your doctor. Throw him a couple of bucks, he patches you up. No questions asked.
He's the guy you go see when you can't go to the hospital, genius.
Why the hell wouldn't you be able to go to the hospital?
Because you go to the hospital with a bullet in you, first thing they do is call the cops.
Yeah. So El Greco deals with a lot of guys in our line of work.
You shouldn't need to visit him, Del Vito. You've always been a quick healer. Must be your diet. Henry, you awake? Stay with me now.
Yeah.
Just hang in there, pal. We'll be at El Greco's in a minute. I can smell the souvlaki from here.
Hey, good afternoon.
Come on, Vito. At this rate, we get there fast if we walk.
How can I help you? A license plate. For you, no problem. Thanks a lot.
Hey, step on it or Henry's done for. If he dies, you're burying him.
Make me drive faster, tu stadezito.
Vito, there. That house. Park right in front.
President Roosevelt.
You El Greco, the doctor?
No, I'm the fucking painter.
A friend needs help, or he's gonna bleed to death.
Thanks, Doc.
Good God, Henry.
We owe you one.
Get him inside. Hello.
Wait, I got money for you. For the job, take it.
You know, this could have waited, but thanks.
And hey, thanks for everything.
I hope you'll be okay.
Yeah, me too.
I'll stay here with Henry. Meet me at my place.
All right.
The stars belong
We interrupt the music to bring you this breaking news. For UCLA, I'm Bob Behrman. There's apparently been a large-scale gunfight at a distillery in Sand Island. And to make matters worse, the distillery is now completely engulfed in flames after the shootout earlier today. Empire Bay police will have to wait until the flames die down to begin their investigation. Now, back to your favorite music on Empire Classic Radio. I'm Bob Behrman.
Just wanted to give you the money to pay off Papa's debt.
Oh, Vito, that's great. I was gonna try and see if we could pay it back in installments. I got a little money. He wouldn't have hurt us.
Don't be so sure, but it doesn't matter now. Here, take
Where'd you get all this money, Vito? You haven't done nothing you'll be sorry for, have you?
Don't worry. Everything's fine.
Thank you, Vito. Thank you.
No problem. All right, look, I better be going. I don't want Ma to see me. She'll be asking where I got the money, too.
Don't worry. I'll make something up.
All right. Give her a big kiss for me,
will.
Okay?
Take care of yourself, Vito.
Oh.